Do another.
I hit.
Yeah, they're really focused on that part.
It's because I have an unsilenced gun.
Okay.
That's brilliant. Keep firing.
Good one.
Should I equip shotgun now, or what?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, I've got eyes on two on the roof.
Okay. We're at the ramp.
That's higher up, though.
Yeah, yeah, of course. But not down here.
Don't blow up.
I definitely got some hits. I got some more hits.
Upstairs.
Move up, move up, push in.
Wait, grenade out.
Okay.
There's stairs.
Yeah, I heard a door.
Rust? So, that zombie actually had some really rare loot on him. He had a research kit and some paper, and what you can do with that is you can actually research any item in the game and find out the crafting material to use to build it, which is actually a very, very rare item to get.
Hey guys, Mike the Vike here, back for yet another video. This time around we're trying out Rust Experimental. This has been in development, obviously, for quite a while, and I've been trying it every couple days. And it's finally gotten to the point where I thought I would show it to you guys. Is it, quote-unquote, playable yet? I'm not quite sure. I don't think the masses will enjoy it just yet. Oh, he looks like he's gone. Oh, there he is. Hello. Oh, does this not function? Is he partially blind? Oh no. Oh!
So, first off, we're going to take a look at the crossbow. Yes, the crossbow is now in. It uses normal arrows at the moment, the same as what your bow and arrow would use. It loads in one at a time. You can aim down sights and shoot. We also have a couple more weapons. We have a mace. We have a salvaged sword. And we have a longsword. Okay, so I got Jacob here. I'm just going to hit him a couple of times with each of the new weapons. Just for effect. Here we go. There's the mace. Oh, nice. Here's the salvaged weapon. And here's the longsword.
This is an overkill. And a half. Oh, he's up in there. Oh, there's a turret. There's a turret up there. It's a turret. Take out the damn turret. Get out the foundations. Where did you just shoot?
Foundations. Right there.
There we go. Fucking rip this base down. Holy shit. Oh shit.
Just keep firing.
Just keep on firing.
The Rust team has made some significant graphical and environmental changes to Rust this week. Starting with the forest biome, the overall look has become more realistic with denser forests, fallen trees, and taller patches of grass. The winter biome has also received a similar feel with the update. Trees are more realistic, and there is now scattered tree branches and logs on the ground. And finally, the desert biome has seen the largest improvement. There is now vegetation that relates to this region. You can now harvest cactuses for cloth, and they also spawn fruit that helps with hydration. Just make sure not to get too cozy, as they deal a small amount of damage and bleed.
Thank you.
hasn't been working properly. Animals have been clipping through rocks and buildings, creating some frustrating situations. Things are going to get better from this point forward with the introduction of the new Animal AI system. This will fix a number of issues that plagued Rust's previous AI system and add in new functionality. First off, with all our testing, we couldn't get animals to run through solid objects in the environment or into bases. I'm not saying that this is 100% fixed, but so far it's looking good. Deers, horses, and boars now have a chance of defending themselves, so be careful attacking these creatures when you have low health. Adding to the realism, animals now have sleeping states, so you can sneak past them if you wish.
This week we have the first big update to the main branch since the last one, and with it, Rust Island just became a much noisier place. As well as the familiar thwack of rock on wood, the twang of string on bow, and the primal roar of a ninja bear attack, we now have a couple of noisy new toys in our arsenal, the first being the long-awaited chainsaw, and the latest. The next new item and a surprise entry is the Spas 12, a new semi-auto shotty that fires almost as fast as you can click, holds 6 shells at a time, and is primarily for the scientists. It's unresearchable and uncraftable, and the only way you'll get your hands on one right now is from airdrops, Bradley, and helicrates. To go with it, we also have a new type of shell, namely incendiary, or dragon's breath, which can be found in airdrops and military crates, researched for 75 scrap and crafted at a tier 2 workbench for 5 frags, 10 gunpowder, and 20 sulfur for a pack of 2.
We'll be starting off with the newest mode of transportation, the minicopter. This chopper has 2 seats and runs off low-grade fuel, and just like the hot air balloon, they're not craftable, so you'll have to find them around the map. You can steer them using your mouse and keyboard, with controls for altitude, pitch, roll, and yaw. They can also get quite high up in the sky and move at a decent speed, but don't think that you're invincible in one of these as the cockpit is quite exposed.
Alright, shoot that sword, and you gotta keep going down. Keep pummeling down.
Yeah.
Fight that! They rocket me in!